thank you so much, everyone. Now we have Stanislav Khoroshulia, who is the senior Android developer and technical leader with MobiDev. He's going to be talking about developing a complex software product, media device management solution. Thank you.
My name is Stanislav Khoroshulia, and I'm a senior developer at MobiDev. MobiDev is a software development company located in Ukraine for 150 software products launched, over 150 in-house employees, and over 50 long-term relationships. Today I would like to talk to you about developing a mobile device management solution. So, what is mobile device management solution? Mobile device management is a secure area dealing with deploying, securing, managing, monitoring devices in the wrong place, such as tablets and smartphones. The intent of mobile device management is to optimize security and functionality of devices in enterprise. Our MDM software consists of many tools that provides functionality such as data transfers, sharing data, patching, delivering fixes to the devices. So currently, all major mobile platforms have mobile device management solutions available to them. And today I would like to talk to you more about Android platform, because Android platform is not only has the biggest market share, but also it's an open platform. So what are the main threats on Android for our users? Well, the first one causes the communication by friends. Basically, it means that some applications are malicious together. It was something with the data. Or even some applications that just have some unintentional bugs that lead to some malicious behavior. The next thing is Nexus exploits. Network exploits usually leverage some errors in the operating system itself, or some operating system that work locally or Wi-Fi network, which allows for remote execution of all your mobile devices. One more issue is stolen of those devices. It's not merely a problem of the platform, but it's a problem threat for your data, your corporate data that's stored on mobile devices. One more issue that we may need for Android platform is fragmentation. It's not really a threat, but due to very big fragmentation on Android platform, we have different APIs for asset performance tools. So that means that we cannot leverage all available functionality of each operating system to protect the data on the phone as much as we want. So, what if it's not enough? What if we want to provide a product that will have consistent functionality across all devices that we might have? What if we want to introduce some new functionality that Android platform doesn't have? So, for that we have, as I said before, one of the major advantages of Android, it's an open platform. Android Open Source Project. Android Open Source Project is a software stack that allows you to port a variety of devices to port Android OS to a variety of mobile devices. So, yeah, that's exactly what we need. And if you want to deliver some customized management system in your company, you can always leverage and build on top of AOSP to provide such functionality. So, the major benefits of building on top of AOSP is it's open source. Which means it's not only we have more eyes on the code. It means that the code might get audited or more people might implement the features that we might want. There are a lot of customized versions of OS built on top of AOSP. Some of them just customized for regular users, such as Cyber Mode. Some of them make emphasis on security, such as, for example, like. And the best part about this is that we can actually build on top of any platform that is open source. Other one is a full control of product. It means that you, as a product owner, will be deciding when to deliver a new feature, when to deliver a new security patch. You're not going to wait for some and leverage all the APIs that are available only to system applications, and also hidden APIs. Hidden APIs is APIs that are stripped out from SDK and are available to regular applications for security reasons. So let's imagine we want to develop something like device. So this will be really straightforward. Android providers with component device management control that has a minute wipe device. So that's it, you push data to the phone. Request the wipe of device, and that's it. But what if device can have no connectivity at all? And we doesn't have connection, so we can't remove the wipe. So one solution will be to implement this feature. And it's actually quite simple. All we need to do is push configuration file to our device during the role, which will say, for example, at which interval we will check if device are able to connect to our servers. And we will include one more policy, for example, how much failed connections to our server we allow. So this way we can ensure that device will be wiped at some interval. Each time it will fail, we will increment the count. And each time it will successfully drop it down back to zero, thus allowing us case of device was lost. Was stolen, for example, in an interval, the device will never get wiped, and sensitive data will be lost. We can even iterate even more by another simple feature. For example, what about when device is turned off? So basically, we have no ability to come. So this is also very simple. All we need to do is, on a boot of device, we just need to check amount of time that passed from the last successful scene or the failed scene, and correlate it between remaining tries for scene of device to ourselves. And that's it, we can wipe device right on the boot of device. This feature is available mostly in all, almost in all MDM solutions currently available for Android. But what I wanted to show is that it's very, very simple if you want to implement it yourself. So another feature that is mandatory for MDM solutions is application management. Application management required to control which applications are installed, how they are updated or removed from the user's device. So this is the first time we hit fragmentation issue. From Android 4 and 5, we don't have an ability to silently install applications on user's device. User will be always prompted with a question, does he want to install this application on his device? The only possibility for us is use Android 6, which has special permission device only, which will allow any application to be silently installed. But unfortunately, Android 6 devices is only approximately 3% of the market. So this is really not an option. So this is a great opportunity to actually leverage use. What we need to do? Well, as I mentioned before, there is a hidden API in a package manager installer, which just says install. That's it. All we need to do is send to device to our device a list of applications. This list of applications will be a long list of applications on the list. So if application is in the list, it will be installed. If some application device is not contained in this list, we will remove it. So this list will contain application, just a simple package name, which is unique identifier, which application, version code, and download. So after that, we just proceed with downloading application and install it. Simple. We can iterate even more on this. So for example, every Android OS has system applications. The system applications cannot be uninstalled. So, but we would like to disable this function. So all we need to do is call disable system application. And that's it. All we need to provide is configuration from which tell our device that will tell which system applications can be disabled, because not all of them can be disabled easily. Then it can lead to malfunctioning devices. So for example, if we disable a phone application, we also have data connectivity or phone connectivity, so basically we disable completely all functionality related to the phone. It's really simple and straightforward. All applications work with sensitive data, and types of sensitive data vary from business to business. That means that each business have to tell their policies to their needs. But as of currently, Android OS provides you with a strict set of policies that you need. There's of course password restrictions, some applications restrictions, but you can actually modify as much as you want. Since Android 5 later, there was introduced a restriction manager for applications. If application defines some list of restrictions, you can get them and disable or enable. But unfortunately, unless we develop these applications or we really trust the developer, we cannot be sure that it's actually abiding by these restrictions and doesn't do anything else. So in this case, what we can do is create new APIs and customize existing ones. Since we have access to application framework level, we can introduce system servers. That, for example, if we want to restrict some applications access to some parts of the system, we can just create a service, system service. System service is a service that starts at the root of Android and runs at a single instance. And this will be a single point of access throughout all the system, because you can get it here practically virtually any part of Android OS system. All we need to add is one simple method. It's restricted. That's it. It will check if some feature is restricted for application and enable it or disable it. But we need to disable it. So to find this, it's actually quite easy. Because, for example, if you want to control Wi-Fi, NFC, USB file transfer, or for example, phone or SMS capabilities, all this can be done through settings of Android networks. So actually, you can just go and see how it's done. Or actually just grab and go, and you actually can do it. But unfortunately, user can go back and change it, or some applications that have appropriate permissions can change it back. So what we would like is for all of these managers, Wi-Fi manager, C, USB manager, to be able during enabling, disabling, or getting some information, be able to check if they are allowed to do so. So this is where our system service that will allow us to check our restrictions currently. All we need to do is, for example, the Wi-Fi manager, when we do set enable, just check if it's allowed. And proceed with procedure of enable or not, the application allowed to enable. The same thing can be done with, for example, telephone service. For example, if you want to disable location tracking, there are different ways to do location tracking. Not only GPS, it's triangulation based on cell towers position, Wi-Fi networks, and so, for example, in these cases, we can introduce, you can check if application has permission to get, for example, a list of cell towers around it. And if it's not, we just return a new or just an empty response. One major point in this case is try to extend the API as much as possible and limit customizations to existing APIs as much as possible. And if customization is done, we should try as much as possible to abide by the contract of some specific vendor. You might have noticed that all the time I always say this feature is simple and really straightforward. And this is actually how it is. Because every complex product built from simple features. Each feature should be simple. And the hardest part is actually to divide on this product when we develop it into these simple features. As I mentioned before, you start with a minimum value feature. So for example, with a Vibe, we added one single functionality, and then we added one more term, and then we added one more term again, until we reach our final goal. And this is the key to developing complex software, starting from simple things, keeping them simple and decoupled until we reach the final goal. This will allow us in the future to easily switch between different APIs. For example, if Google releases some new APIs available to us, and we would like to switch and not support our code by using an existing one. One major problem here is developers' problems. Because as practice shows, almost no one in your company or any other company that does software development in Android has a knowledge of chaos technology. It's a very huge and technology time and numbers. Because every single feature you want to implement is always will take a lot of time to analyze for implementation. It's to investigate how it should be done, and estimation is also done. So ideally, it would be great if you can find some people that already have experience with this. All I described right now is developing iteration process. It's only a small part of the process of process development. And if you'd like to know more about the whole development process, my colleague Alexander will be able to talk on this topic tomorrow. So far we didn't talk about changes on the ground. This topic is enough for a separate talk. But I want you to understand that this is one of the most profitable areas for modification. Because on this level you can do so much more. You can change the boot sequence of the device, introduce new checks, validations, so you can provide the check integrity for the device. You can even fix bugs that usually would prevent you from using the device, or deliver as fast as possible fixes for your device. So for example, with sleep stage fry, as soon as Google released the security patch for it, you can just grab the code because it's open source, put it in your code base, and just deliver it to users immediately, not waiting until different vendors and carriers will deliver some security patch. Or they might not even deliver any time. So this is a huge advantage. For example, if you wanted to fix some bugs on kernel, we had one issue with the client that he had an issue with a device that was USB file transfer management, it was a requirement, we restricted control restrictions on it. When you disable all of it, kernel actually will enable it to be. So in this case, you would need to reach this device from your whole devices. So, and we were able to fix it in fast manage. It was a simple, just minor mistake in the code, and we fixed it again. Our client was happy to keep the device, this useful analysis. But there are some caveats in working with AUSP. So, in case you don't work with your own product, your own hardware that you produce, you have to rely on phones and tablets that are already available on the market. So the problem with this is warranty. To flash a new OS on your device, you have to unlock your device for bootloader, which in many cases leads to you losing the warranty on this device. The next one is find a suitable device. After unlocking a device, you have to lock it, and some devices doesn't allow it. And this is a huge vulnerability if you can't lock it there. Some of the devices have more strict restrictions for unlocking them. This is a problem because most of devices like this you won't be able to use them. One more thing is that some devices, for example, like a lot of Chinese phone, doesn't release to open source some code that they should. So this leaves you also not able to. You are not able to use them too because of that. One of the most prevalent problems with this is Google Play services. When you develop a new custom Android operating system, you lose Google Play services. Google Play services, for example, is a proprietary software that Google develops. It's, for example, Play Market and Play Market API, which means that you lose some applications that heavily use these APIs might not function properly. That's why I told you before that you should try to apply with the control of the matter and always extend API instead of customizing it. Because you can, there is a compatibility test that after developing a customized, you can pass it. And if you pass it, you can apply for Google for receiving a license for use of Google Play services. Also, you have a full control of your product. So, I mentioned this in the benefits, but this is also a negative. This is a double-edged sword. You're not only able to control your product, deliver all features you want, prioritize your needs, and do such things, but now you are responsible. So if you deliver this product to your users and your clients, you will need to be responsible for delivering security fixes, updates, and you will be stuck with it for a long time. But the main point of this is that building on top of ASP is giving you great flexibility. You can do almost everything you want. The things I described today was just a simple thing. It's just a tip of an iceberg what you can do on Android One. You can modify it any way you want. And not only build it in MDM solutions, you can actually do literally anything you want. Delivering the product you want, the product you imagine, and how you see it working.